everyone, welcome back to my channel, Annette Journey Starring Annette. That's me. It's your favorite real estate professional back at it again with another video. This time I'm going to be talking about what is a REIT, okay? But before we get into the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll very much appreciate it. Don't forget to hit that notification bell because I will be posting every single Saturday and you don't want to miss it. Now let's get into the video. Okay, so what is a REIT, right? A REIT is an investment trust that owns and manages a pool of commercial properties, mortgages, and other real estate assets. Shares can be bought and sold in a stock market. Now, a REIT functions much like an ETF or mutual fund, where it bundles ownership of various assets and then provide dividends from those sources, right? So what we love is dividends. The two REITs I'm going to be talking about are equity REITs and mortgage REITs. And my favorite REIT, of course, is an equity REIT. And you'll understand a little bit more about why I love equity REITs as I go into depth about what is an equity REIT, okay? So an equity REIT is the most common REIT, right? And with the equity REIT, the company owns or manages income-producing real estate, okay? And most of the income that is being produced is from collecting rent from those properties, okay? But they may also make money by property sales as well. With the equity REIT, they own many different property types, such as office buildings, shopping centers, industrial warehouses, you know, or factories. And most of that money is being made off the, most of the income, shall I say, is being made from the rent that is being collected from those tenants who rent out those properties, okay? Now I'm going to be showing you a graph, and the graph is just basically going to explain the process of an equity REIT, right? The process as an investor, the shareholder, the owner, and how the dividends are being distributed back to the investors and so forth, okay? So here we have the equity REIT graph, right? And it starts off with us as individual investors. You know, that's who we are, the individual investors, whether it's me, you, grandma, grandpa, your friend, your uncle, your cousin, your mother, and so on, right? We are able to purchase shares of that equity REIT, whether it's residential or commercial, and allowing us to acquire real estate, right? And real estate, of course, is assets over liabilities, right? Now, with those assets, they are able to generate rental income, right? So these assets, these properties is being owned and occupied by tenants. And these tenants are renting it out and they're, you know, paying their rent money every month or whatever. And now that income is being produced into these equity REITs, which now we're able to receive periodic distributions, right? So we're able to receive our dividends based off the income that is being produced from the collection of the rent, okay? Now, I hope, you know, this gives you a better understanding
next
of equity
REITs. Mortgage REITs. So mortgage REITs, commonly known as MREITs, right? They're much different than an equity REIT. How they function is that the company does not own the property itself. Instead, they provide loans to real estate owners and their income is being produced based off the interest earned, okay? And also with them, they basically finance both residential and commercial properties, but most of that revenue come from investments that are in mortgages and mortgage-backed securities, okay? Now, I'm going to talk a little bit more about mortgage equity. I'm going to pull up a graph and explain to you a little bit more about the process of that.
Okay, so now we have the mortgage REITs graph. Now, like I said before, the mortgage REITs function much different than an equity REIT. It's way more complex because of the fact that instead of the company owning the property itself, they're providing loans given to real estate owners, okay? So we're going to start off as the investors, you and I. And as the investors, there is an indirect investment going towards the mortgage REITs, right? Which is principal and interest going down to the money lenders, right? Now, after that process happens, now it becomes direct investment, which goes to mortgage-backed security, right? And then the bond sale proceeds to the mortgage-backed security issue, such as, you know, Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, right? They're the ones who buy the mortgage, sends it to the moneylender. The moneylender funds the buyer or the real estate owners, and now we're able to buy property based off the loan that we just got, right? Now, after we're buying that property, though, now there's principal and interest fees, right? Which goes to the mortgage service, the servicer, which is now principal and interest going towards the mortgage-backed security issues, right? So now it's going back to them. And then more principal and interest, right? Which more principal and interest, right? Going towards the money, the mortgage REIT, sorry. Now from that money loan, there now the funds are able to be distributed into dividends, allowing investors to receive that dividends, okay? So it's a little more complex, like I said, because of the fact that you're taking out a loan in order to buy the real estate property. You know, I hope that explains the whole process of mortgage REITs, you know, how they're being processed from the investor to the buyer, back from the buyer to the investor as dividends.
Now, I hope you guys were able to understand the difference between equity REITs and mortgage REITs and understand a little bit more why I prefer equity REITs over mortgage REITs. Of course, it's solely up to you to decide on what you prefer, whether it's the mortgage REIT or equity REIT. Like I said, I am not a financial advisor, so disclaimer, I'm not telling you guys to go buy up a bunch of equity REITs or mortgage REITs. Always do your research before you buy any stock, whether it's an individual stock, a REIT, you know, or even if you're day trading, or even if you're buying crypto. Make sure you do your research first. That's very important, okay? Now I am going to talk about different types of REITs and the property types to help you better understand in each different field what type of property types are being bought and sold.
Okay, so the different type of REITs that we have is healthcare, and the property types are hospitals, rehab centers, medical offices, and even senior housing. Next, we have hospitality, which is hotels, resorts, restaurants, theme parks. Then we have industrial, which is distribution centers, factories, warehouses, you know, something like an Amazon warehouse. Next, we have infrastructure, which is cell towers, cable networks, and even pipelines. Then we have office, you know, and there are office buildings, business parks. Then we have residential, which of course are apartment buildings, dormitories, and even rental homes. Then we have retail, which is malls, shopping centers, and even freestanding stores. Then we have storage, which are self-storage units, computer data centers. And last, we have timberland, which is, you know, forest land itself, as well as like the woods, okay?
I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope I was able to explain what a REIT is and what are the two most common known REITs, which is equity and mortgage REITs. If you like more videos like this, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit that notification bell. In my next video, I will be talking about another REIT that I own, which is OVRLT, and I'll talk about the pros of owning this REIT as well as a little more background history of what is OVRLT, okay, right? Now, thank you guys. I hope you're having a lovely weekend. Continue to have a great weekend and a great week coming up. Thank you.